Hello, 8th graders. This is Teacher Monica, and welcome to our discussion on Quarter 4 lessons. Module 1 lessons discusses theorems on triangle inequalities, and this learning material will help you master theorems on triangle inequalities, applies these theorems on triangle inequalities, and prove triangle inequalities. For this video lesson, we will be discussing the theorems on triangle inequalities in one triangle, particularly on triangle inequality theorem, angle side inequality theorem, side angle inequality theorem, and exterior angle inequality theorem. Now, I have here triangle ABC with sides E, F, and G. So I want you to complete this table. You get any two sides of the given triangle and identify the third side. So kahit saang sides po dito, kukuha tayo ng tigda dalawa or any two sides. And then i-identify natin yung third side. So say for example, we have side E and F. And the third side is side G. So, kung ang kukunin naman nating sides are E and G, the third side is F. And kung ang kukunin naman natin na sides are F and G, the third side is E. So, this time, let us give the measures of each side based on the illustration. So we have E is 6, F is 9, and G is 11. So E 6, G 11, F is 9. F is 9, G is 11, and E is 6. So this time we are going to get the sum of the identified pairs of sides. So, kukunin natin yung sum ng two sides. So, for side E and F, the sum is 15. The third side is 11. For E and G, the sum is 17 and the third side is 9. So, for F and G, the sum is 20 and the third side is 6. So, if you have noticed, all the sums of the identified pairs of sides are greater than the third side. So, 15 is greater than 11, 17 is greater than 9, 20 is greater than 6. Okay, so meaning the sum of the two sides, E and F, is greater than side G. The sum of the two sides E and G is greater than side F. And the sum of the two sides F and G is greater than side E. So we can now conclude that the sum of the lengths of any two sides is greater than the length of the third side. So, yung sum ng dalawang side, any two sides na pinili natin kanina, their sum is always greater than the third side. And that is the theorem on triangle inequalities. Now, if you come across with this question, which of the following could be the length of the side of a triangle? So how are you going to determine if the given sides can possibly form a triangle? So don't forget the theorem that in a triangle, the sum of the lengths of any two sides is greater than the length of the third side. So dapat yung sum ng dalawang side ay greater kesa doon sa length ng third side. So, kahit sa ang two sides, dapat mas greater ang kanyang measurement or the sum of their measurement kesa doon sa third side. That is to determine if we can possibly make a triangle. Okay, let's discover or let's have an example. Which of the following could be the lengths of the sides of a triangle? So, I have here three sets of the sides of a given figure. And we are going to determine alin dito sa tatlong set of sides ang pwedeng makakabuo ng triangle. So, do not forget that in a triangle, dapat yung sum ng any two sides ay greater kaysa length ng third side para makakabuo po tayo ng triangle. So, let us identify pairs or two pairs of sides. So, for set A, we can have 7 and 4 as our two sides and the third side is 5. Let us have again another two sets or two sides, side 4 and 5, and the third side is 7. Next, we have the two sides na pipiliin natin is 7 and 5, and the third side is 4. So, remember, dapat ang sum nitong two sides dito ay greater than the side or the third side. So, let us see kung greater ba sila. So, 7 plus 4, the first two sides, 7 plus 4 is 12. And 12 is greater than 5. So, that is true. Kung ang pipili nating two sides ay the side that measures 4 and 5, so that is 9. The third side is 7. So, the sum of 4 and 5 is 9, and 9 is greater than 7. So, that is true. And the third pair of sides are sides that measure 7 and 5, and that is 12. The third side is 4. So, 12 is greater than 4. So, that is still true. Now, kung nag-true yung tatlo, after we have selected the pairs of sides. So, pag nag-true yan siya, na greater sila kaysa sa third side, meaning the sides that measures 7, 4, and 5 can make a triangle. Okay, let's have set B. Tingnan natin if itong sides that measures 9, 11, and 2 can possibly make a triangle. So again, paano natin malalaman? Dapat kung ang sum ng any two sides ay greater than the third side at nag-true silang tatlo, ibig sabihin, we can make a triangle out of these measurements. So let us try. The first two sides measures 9 and 11, and the third side is 2. Next two pairs of sides are 11 and 2, and the third side measures 9. And another pair of sides we have 9 and 2, and then the third side is 11. So let us see. Kung ang sum ba ng two sides na ito dito ay greater than the third side. So, we have 9 plus 11, that is 20, and 20 is greater than 2. So, that is true. Next, we have 11 plus 2, that is 13, and 13 is greater than 9. So, that is true. Next, we have 9 and 2, that is 11. So is 11 greater than 11? That is false. Bakit? Because they are equal. So kung titingnan natin dito, merong isa na nag-false. So kung merong isang nag-false out of 3 na consideration, ay hindi po tayo makakabuo ng triangle. So dapat mag-true yung tatlong condition or sides dito na dapat ay greater siya sa third side. So pag mag-true yung tatlo, then we can make a triangle. But in this case, meron tayong false. So meaning 9, 11, and 2 cannot be used as a length of the sides because it cannot make a triangle. Next, we have set C. So we have 12, 10, and 12. So we are going to select again two sides, any two sides. So first side, so we can have 12 and 10, and the third side is 12. Another pair, so we have 10 plus 12, and the third side is 12. Another pair, we have 12 and 12, and the third side is 10. So let us see if the sum of these pairs are greater than the third side. So let us see, 12 plus 10, that is 22, and 22 is greater than 12, so that is true. So 10 plus 12, that is 22. 22 is greater than 12, so that is true. So 12 plus 12, that is 24, and 24 is greater than 10, and that is true. Now, since nag-true yung tatlo, so ibig sabihin, the figure that has sides 12, 10, and 12 can make a triangle. Now, let us take this example. Can a triangle be constructed with sides of lengths 12 cm, 24 cm, and 18 cm? So, para malaman natin, let us always remember that in a triangle, the sum of the lengths of any two sides is greater than the length of the third side. So, if we have two sides, 12 and 18, so that is our first two sides. So, the third side is 24. Now, if we are going to add 12 and 18, that is 30, and 30 is greater than 24. That is true. Next, if we have another two pairs of side 12 and 24, the third side is 18. So 12 and 24, is that greater than 18? 12 plus 24 will give us 36, and 36 is greater than 18. So that is true. And another pair of sides we have 18 plus 24, and the third side is 12. So, is 18 plus 24 greater than 12? 18 plus 24 will give us 42, and 42 is greater than 12. That is true. Since nag-true yung tatlo, after pairing, after getting any two pairs from the given measurement or length of the sides. So, nag-true sila, therefore, we can say that a triangle can be constructed. Again, a triangle can only be constructed if the sum of any two sides is greater than the third side. So, in this case, in our example, nag-true yung tatlo. Yung tatlong pairs, nag-true siya, nag-greater siya sa third sides. Kaya, a triangle can be constructed. Okay, let us take another example. Can a triangle be constructed with sides of lengths 6 centimeters, 2 centimeters, and 7 centimeters. So, para malaman natin, always remember that the sum of the lengths of the any two sides is greater than the length of the third side. Now, if we are going to choose two sides that measures 6 and 2 centimeters, our third side will be 7. So, getting the sum of the two sides 6 and 2, that will give us 8. Is 8 greater than the third side 7? True. Yes, it is. So, another pair of sides, we have 2 and 7. So, our third side is the side that measures 6 centimeters. Getting the sum of the lengths of the two sides, that will give us 9. Is 9 greater than the third side 6? Yes, it's true. And if the two sides are the sides that measure 7 and 6 centimeters, of course, our third side is 2 centimeters. Getting the sum of the two sides, 7 and 6, that will give us 13. Is 13 greater than the length of the third side, which is 2? Yes, it is. So, kasi nag-true sila, therefore, a triangle can be constructed. A triangle with sides 6 centimeters, 2 centimeters, and 7 centimeters can be constructed. Okay, let us have another example. Can a triangle be constructed with a sides of length 6 centimeters, 11 centimeters, and 4 centimeters? So, tandaan natin that in a triangle, dapat ang sum of the lengths ng dalawang side is greater than the length of the third side. Nang sa ganun ay makakagawa tayo ng triangle. So, let us take the first two sides. Sides that measures 6 centimeters and 11 centimeters. Of course, the third side will be 4. So, getting the sum of the first two, or the 6 and 11 centimeters, that will give us 17. Is 17 greater than the length of the third side, which is 4? Yes, it's true. So, how about getting the pair 4 and 11? So, our third side will be 6. Getting the sum of the two sides, 4 and 11, that will give us 15. Is 15 greater than the length of the third side, which is 6? So we have 2. And the last pair, we have 6 and 4. Here, our third side is 11. Now, getting the sum of the two sides, 6 and 4, that will give us 10. And is that greater than the length of the third side, which is 11? False. So, dahil meron tayong false, ibig sabihin, merong isang condition dito na hindi pupwede, na siyang magiging dahilan na hindi tayo makakapag-construct ng triangle. So, we have here, false, therefore, a triangle cannot be constructed. Kasi dapat, para makapag-construct tayo ng triangle, ang side ng any of the two, the sum of the sides, ay greater than the length of the third side. Now, I want you to take a look at this figure. The figure shows that triangle JOY has unequal sides. Side JY measures 10 centimeters, side YO measures 8 centimeters, and side OJ measures 7 centimeters. So these sides can be arranged in this order. So side JY, having the measure of 10 centimeters, is greater Then, side YO having 8 centimeters, and that is greater than side OJ having 7 centimeters. Now, look at the measures of the angles opposite these sides. So, the angle opposite the side JY is angle O, and that measures 85 degrees. The angle opposite side YO is angle J, and that measures 55 degrees. And the angle opposite side OJ is angle Y, and that is that measures 40 degrees. Now observe that the opposite angles are also unequal in the same order as that of the sides. So we can also arrange the angles according to this. So we have the measure of angle O is greater than the measure of angle J and is greater than the measure of angle Y. So, kung titingnan natin, the angle O here that measures 85 degrees, yun yung merong pinaka malaking measure of angle. At ang opposite niya na side is side JY. At yun din ang merong pinaka malaking measure ng length. Then we have here angle J, yun yung pangalawa sa may pinakamalaki. So 55 degrees. At ang opposite niya, yun din yung may pangalawang may pinakamalaki na or pinakamataas na length, which is 8 centimeters. And we have angle Y, yung may pinakamaliit na measure, ang opposite side niya, yun din ang merong pinakamaliit na measure ng length of sides. So, this will lead us into discussing the next topic about angle-side relationship theorem and arranging the angles and sides in ascending and descending orders. Okay, this time we're going to discuss the angle-side relationship theorem. So, from the given figure, we have there triangle MPS. So, I would like you to give the angles and its opposite sides. So, the given angles here are angle M, we have angle S, and angle P. And the opposite side is the opposite side, yung katapat niya. So we have side PS or side SP. Next we have angle S. Ano yung side na opposite niya? Ito. So we have side MP. Next we have angle P. So, what is the side opposite angle P? So, we have here side MS. Okay? Now, given the measure of the angles as angle M, which is 75 degrees, we have angle S is 45 degrees, and angle P, which is 60 degrees. And the measure of the opposite side, so we have side SP, the measure is 14 centimeters. For side MP, we have 8. And for side MS, we have 10. Now, we are going to identify the largest angle, the smallest angle, the longest side, and the shortest side. So, from the given measures of angle, which angle has the largest angle or the largest measure of an angle? So we have angle M is the largest angle and The smallest angle is angle S. How about the sides? So the longest side is side SP. That measures 14 centimeters. And the shortest side is side MP, and that is, or that measures 8 centimeters. Now, if you have noticed, the largest angle, ang opposite niya is also yung side having the longest measure or the longest length. Okay? Measure of length. At yung smallest angle, we have here the smallest angle, ang opposite side niya, yun din yung merong pinakamaliit or na measure ng length, or we have the shortest side. Now that you have already identified the largest angle, the smallest angle, the longest side, and the shortest side, we are now going to relate that to this theorem. So we have the angle side inequality theorem. At yan ay tinatawag din na unequal angles theorem. So ibig sabihin, ang focus natin dito or ang pinag-uusapan natin dito ay ang angles. Okay? So ano ang sinasabi sa angle side inequality theorem? It says that if one angle of a triangle is larger than the other angle, then the side opposite the larger angle is the longer side. So, sabi ko kanina, ang pinag-uusapan natin dito ay ang angle. So, ang sinasabi sa angle side inequality theorem, kung sino daw yung merong pinakamalaki na measure of angle, or the largest angle, ang opposite side niya, yun yung merong pinaka mahaba na measure of length. So the angle or the largest angle, ang opposite niya is also the longest side. Okay? So yan yung sinasabi sa angle side inequality theorem. Again, ang focus dito is the angle. Next, we have the side angle inequality theorem. So, we also call that as an unequal sides theorem. So, ang focus naman natin dito sa side angle inequality theorem is the side. So, anong sinasabi sa theorem nito? It says that if one side of a triangle is longer than the other side, then the angle opposite the longer side is the larger angle. So, titingnan natin ngayon kung sino yung may pinakamahaba na side. So, the longest side in this case is side SP, and that measures 14 centimeters. So, since ang side SP ang mayroong longest side, ang opposite na angle niya, yun yung merong pinakamalaki na measure of angle, or the angle having the largest measure. So, the longest side is SP, and opposite angle niya is also the largest angle, and that is angle M. Again, pag sinabi natin angle side inequality theorem, the focus natin is angle. So, kung sino yung may pinakamalaking angle, ang una nating titingnan is the measure of the angle. Kung ano yung mayroong pinakamalaking measure ng angle, opposite niyan na side, yun din ang expected na merong pinakamahabang side or measure of side. Ang sa side angle inequality theorem, ang focus natin is side. So, ang una mong titingnan, ang measure ng sides. Kung ano yung merong longest side, automatic, ang opposite angle niya, yun din ang merong pinaka malaking measure of angle or the largest angle. Okay, this time we are going to learn how to arrange the angles or the sides in descending and ascending order. So in this case, We are going to arrange the angles from the largest to the smallest. So, pag sinabi natin largest to smallest angle, yun ay descending order mula sa pinakamalaki hanggang sa pinakamaliit. So, kapag sinabi naman natin ascending order, we will start from the smallest to the largest angle. Now, the question is, can we identify what is the largest or the smallest angle kung ang ibinigay lang ay ang measure ng ating mga sides? Kasi if you have noticed in the figure, walang nakalagay na measure of angles. Ang nakalagay lang ay measures ng length ng mga sides. So, can we identify alin sa mga angles na ito ang pinakamalaki ang measure, alin ang pinakamaliit ang measure? So, we can identify. Balikan natin yung theorem na pinag-aralan natin kanina, the side angle inequality theorem. So, anong nakalagay sa side angle inequality theorem? If one side of a triangle is longer than the other side, then the angle opposite the longer side is the larger angle. So, meaning to say, kung ang binigay lang dyan ay measure ng sides, walang nakalagay na measure of angle, paano natin hanapin kung alin ang largest angle at alin ang smallest angle? So, based on the theorem, we have there an equal side theorem. Okay, so titingnan natin ngayon ang mga measure of the sides. Okay, sa measure of sides ang ating titingnan. So, paano natin kukunin ang largest angle given the measure of the sides? So, according to the theorem, kung ano daw yung merong pinakamahaba na side or measure ng side. Opposite of that is the largest angle. Okay? So, in that case, our longest side is side SP or side PS. Opposite of that, yun yung angle na pinakamalaki ang measure. Okay? Since ito yung may pinakamahabang measure, opposite of the longest side, that is the largest angle. So, in this case, the largest angle is angle M. Then, ang shortest side, which is side MP or side PM, having the measure of 8 centimeters. So, this is the shortest side. So, opposite of the shortest side, yun din yung merong pinakamaliit na measure of angle. So, the smallest angle is angle S. Okay? So, yung angle P, yun yung ilalagay natin sa gitna. So, if you are going to arrange that in descending order, pag sinabing descending, largest to smallest. So, we have angle M is greater than angle P and greater than angle S. So, this is the descending order of the angle. Again, pag descending order of an angle, we will start from the angle having the largest measure to the angle having the lowest measure. Balik tayo. Kahit hindi nakalagay dyan ang measure of an angle, we can determine alin dyan ang largest angle at ang smallest angle based on the given measure of sides. So, yung pinakamalaking side or pinakamahabang side, opposite of that, yun yung pinakamalaki na measure of an angle. So, we can also arrange that angles in ascending order. Pag sinabi nating ascending order, we will start from the smallest to the largest angle. So, we have The smallest angle is angle S. And the largest angle is angle M. So, yung nasa gitna is si angle P. So, ang arrangement natin is ganyan. From smallest to largest. Angle S is less than angle P and angle P is less than angle M. So, this is ascending order. Again, pag descending order from largest to the smallest angle. Pag sinabi natin ascending from smallest to largest angle. How about if the given figure only shows the measures of the angles? Hindi nakalagay ang measure ng ating mga sides. So, how are we going to determine the longest side and the shortest side? And how are we going to arrange that in descending and ascending order? So, we will go back to the theorem. The angle side inequality theorem or the unequal angles theorem. Meaning to say, titingnan natin ang mga given angles. So, anong nakalagay sa theorem na yan? It says that if one angle of a triangle is larger than the other angle, then the side opposite the larger angle is the longer side. So, in this example, the largest angle is angle M, and that measures 75 degrees. So, opposite the larger angle, that is our longest side. Again, opposite the largest angle is the longest side. So, in this case, the longest side is side SP or side PS. And the smallest angle is angle S, and that measures 45 degrees. Opposite the smallest angle, that is our shortest side. So, the shortest side here is side MP or side PM. So, yung nasa gitna is side SM or side MS. So, this is, if we're going to arrange that in descending order, so we have side SP is greater than side MS, and side MS is greater than side MP. So, this is descending order from longest to the shortest side. And if we're going to arrange that in ascending order, we will start from the shortest side. So, the shortest side is side MP. And the longest side is side SP. So, the arrangement will be side MP is less than side MS. Side MS is less than side SP. Okay, now, let us take this example. So, we are going to arrange the angles in descending order. Take note, descending from the largest angle to the lowest angle or the smallest angle. Now, since angle ang ating hinahanap, we are going to apply the side angle theorem wherein ang titingnan natin ay ang measure of the sides. Kasi ang sabi, if one side of a triangle is longer than the other side, then the angle opposite the longer side is the larger angle. Again, ang hinahanap natin ay ang angles. Okay? So, we are going to base that on the given measures of the sides. At i-arrange daw natin yan in descending order. Meaning, mula sa merong pinakamalaki na measure of an angle hanggang sa pinakamaliit na measure of an angle. So, how are you going to find it? Ang merong pinakamahaba na measure of sides ay si side BU or side UB. Therefore, ang largest angle ay yung opposite niyan, and that is angle S. At ang shortest side is side BS or side SB. Therefore, ang opposite side niya or ang opposite angle niya is angle U. Kaya if we are going to arrange that from according to descending order, so we have angle S is greater than angle B and greater than angle U. So si angle S yung merong pinakamalaking measure of an angle at si angle U ang siyang merong pinakamaliit na measure of an angle. Okay, let us have another example. So we are going to arrange the sides in descending order. Take note, sides ang ating i-arrange. But in the figure, hindi nakalagay ang measure of the sides. So paano natin malaman ngayon aling side ang merong pinakamahabang measure at alin ang merong pinakamaliit na measure? So applying the angle side theorem or unequal angles theorem. So doon tayo magbe-base sa given measure of angles. So ano nakalagay sa theorem na yan? It says that if one angle of a triangle is larger than the other angle, then the angle opposite the larger angle is the longer side. So, hanapin natin yung angle na merong pinakamalaki na measure at ang opposite nun, yun ang side na longest. But in our given example or in our given figure, only two angles ang merong measure. The measure of angle L is not given. So how are we going to do it? Recall that the sum of the measures of the interior angle is 180 degrees. The sum of the interior angles dapat ay 180 degrees. So ilan kaya ang measure of angle L? So how are we going to find the measure of angle L? So we have the measure of angle L is 180 minus the sum of the measures of the given two angles, 70 degrees and 85 degrees. So we have angle L is equal to 180 minus 155 degrees, and that is 25 degrees. So the measure of angle L now is 25 degrees. Now, meron ng kumpletong measure of the angles. So, ito na ngayon ang pagbabasihan natin to determine what is the longest side and what is the shortest side. So, in that case, the greater or the angles having the largest measure is angle G. So, that is 85 degrees. And the side opposite angle G is side BL or side LB. At yun ang mayroong longest side. And that is the longest side, side BL. Now, what is the shortest side? So, tingnan natin yung mayroong pinakamaliit na measure of an angle. And that is angle L, which is 25 degrees. Opposite niyan is side GB or side BG. At yun ang merong pinakamaliit na measure of the side. So, if we are going to arrange that in descending order, so we have side BL is greater than side GL and greater than side BG. So, ang longest side is side BL and the shortest side is side BG. Okay, so let us try this one. Give the longest side in each triangle. Show your solution. So I will be giving you 5 minutes to do this activity. Thank you. Okay, time is up. So we're now going to check the activity. So it says that you are going to give the longest side in each triangle. Take note, ang hinahanap dito is the longest side. So, before we can identify the longest side, dapat alamin muna natin what is the largest angle in the triangle. Because opposite the largest angle, yun yung longest side. But in the figure, angle J ay hindi binigay ang measure. So we are going to find first the measure of angle J. So how are we going to find it? Remember that the sum of the measures of the interior angle is 180 degrees. So i-less natin yung dalawang measure of the angles na binigay. So 50 and 70. So we have 180 minus 120. So that is 60 degrees. Therefore, the measure of angle J is 60 degrees. Now, meron na tayong measures ng tatlong interior angles. So we are now going to identify alin dyan ang largest angle. So in this example, the largest angle is angle Y, and that measures 70 degrees. Opposite the largest angle is the longest side. So ito yung opposite niya. So ang opposite niya is side JO or side OJ. So that is the longest side. Okay? So opposite the largest angle, which is 70 degrees of angle Y, opposite of that, that is the longest side. So for number one, the longest side is side JO. Okay, next we have number two. So same siya ng case sa number one. Meron siyang missing angle, which is angle I. So since missing yan, we cannot identify first yet the longest side. So we are going to find first the measure of angle I. So we have 180 minus the measure of the two angles, 59 and 70. So we have 180 minus 129, and that will give us 51 degrees. So the measure of angle I is 51 degrees. Now, alin dito ang largest angle? So we have 59, 51, and 70 degrees. So the largest angle is angle A, and that is 70 degrees. Therefore, opposite the largest angle, that is the longest side. So in number two, the longest side is side ZI or side IZ. Okay, so we have now number three. In determining the longest side for number 3 or angle GAB, we are going to find first the largest angle because opposite the largest angle, that is the longest side. But in this figure, only angle A has an exact measure and that is 40 degrees. While angle G and angle B, we cannot determine the exact value or the exact measurement of their angles because we still have here a variable x. So we are going to find first the variable, the value of the variable x so that we can start substitute later and find the exact value or the exact measurement of angle G and angle B. So how are we going to find the measurement of angle G and angle B? So let us always remember that the sum of all the interior angles of a triangle is 180. Since angle A has 40 degrees na measure, we are going to less that from 180. So 180 minus 40, that is 140. So meaning, itong 140, this will be the sum of the two angles, angle G and angle B. So, ito dapat yung sum nila. Now, we are going to add muna itong dalawang expression. So we have 3x plus 60 and 2x plus 45. Dapat yan ay mag-equal to 140. Kasi yun na lang ang naiwan. Kasi meron ng angle A which is 40 degrees. Now, we are going to combine like terms. So, yung merong mga variable, i-combine natin. So, 3x plus 2x. And then, the constant term, i-combine din natin. So, you have 60 plus 45. So, this is equal to 140. Now, 3x plus 2x will give us 5x. And then, 60 plus 45 will give us 105. And this will be equal to 140. Now, since we are looking for the value of the variable x, so we are going to transpose 105 to the opposite side. I-combine natin yung constant terms. So we have 5x is equal to 140 minus 105. So that will give us 5x is equal to 35. Now, since we're looking for x, we are going to divide both sides by 5. So we have 5x divided by 5 is equal to 35 divided by 5. So 5x divided by 5 will give us x. 35 divided by 5 will give us 7. Therefore, the value of x is 7. Now, after getting the value of x, we are going to substitute that to this expression. So, we have 3 times x will give us 21 plus 60. That will give us 81 degrees. While in the second expression, we have 2 times 7. That will give us 14 plus 45. That will give us a total of 59. Therefore, angle G measures 81 degrees and angle B measures 49 degrees. So, if we are going to add these two, that will give us 140 plus 40. So, the sum of all the interior angles is 180. Now, since meron na tayong kompleto na mga measure of angles, we are now going to identify the largest angle. So, alin ang largest angle natin dyan? So, we have angle G that measures 81 degrees. So, we can now determine the longest side. Kahit hindi nakalagay dyan ang measure, we can already determine the longest side because we have already identified the largest angle. So, it says that opposite the largest angle, that is the longest side. So, therefore, our longest side is side AB or side BA. Okay, this time we are going to discuss the exterior angle inequality theorem. Now, take a look at this figure. Always remember that a triangle has 3 interior angles. So, in this triangle, we have 3 interior angles. And these are angle 1, angle 2, and angle 3. Now, pag sinabi natin exterior angles, ito yung mga angles na nasa labas ng ating triangle. So, how are we going to find the exterior angles in this figure? So, if we are going to extend the sides of this triangle, we can have the exterior angles. So, we have for interior angle 1, ay meron tayong tatlong exterior angles. So, you have 1, 2, 3. For angle 2, ay meron ding tatlong exterior angles na nabuo. So, we have 1, 2, and 3 angles. Same with angle 3. Meron ding tatlong nabuong exterior angles. But when we say exterior angle of a triangle that refers to the angles which form a linear pair with one of the triangle's interior angle. So, ibig sabihin, linear pair siya or adjacent siya ng isa sa mga interior angles. So, pag sinabi natin linear pairs, meron silang common side and common vertex. So, say for example, for our angle 1, ito yung kanyang dalawang exterior angle. So, bakit sila tinawag na exterior angle? Kasi yan ay adjacent to angle 1. So, this angle is adjacent to angle 1. They have common side and common vertex. This angle here, also called as the exterior angle because it is adjacent to angle 1. Again, pag sinabi natin adjacent, meron silang common vertex. Linear pair sila dahil meron din silang common side and common vertex. So, for angle 2, same. So, ang adjacent to angle 2, we have angle 6 and angle 7. So, ito yung tinatawag natin na exterior angle of the triangle for angle 2. And for angle 3, the exterior angles are ito, angle 8 and angle 9. So, bakit ito? Because angle 8 is adjacent to angle 3. And angle 9 is also adjacent to angle 3. Kaya sila tinawag na exterior angles. So, meaning, for angle 1, the exterior angles are angle 4 and angle 5. For angle 2, the exterior angles are angle 6 and angle 7. And for angle 3, the exterior angles are angle 8 and angle 9. So, ang tanong ngayon, bakit hindi kasali itong angle na ito as exterior angle of angle 1? Because itong angle na ito is not adjacent to angle 1. Walang linear pair na nabuo. Kasi angle 1 at ito na angle ay wala silang common side. So, dapat kasi linear pair. There is a common side and there is a common vertex. So, same with there, hindi siya matawag na exterior angle of a triangle. Kasi, hindi siya adjacent to angle 2. Same here, this is not included kasi hindi siya adjacent to angle 3. So, pero, pwede natin silang tawagin as vertical angle. Itong angle 1 at ito na angle ay vertical angle. So, when we say vertical angle, opposite angles yan. So, angle 1, vertical angle niya ito. Angle 2, ito yung kanyang vertical angle. Angle 3, ito din yung kanyang vertical angle. Now, take note that for every pair of exterior angles, matatawag din silang vertical angles. Kasi opposite angles din yan sila. So, say for example, angle 8 and angle 9 are vertical angles because they are also opposite angles. Angle 4 and angle 5 are also vertical angles. And angle 6 and angle 7 are also vertical angles. Now, let's talk about the remote interior angles. So, kapag sinabi natin remote interior angles, these are two interior angles not adjacent to the exterior angles. So, hindi siya adjacent to the exterior angles. So, Alin dito ngayon ang tinatawag nating mga remote interior angles. So, say for example, angle 5. Ito yung angle 5 natin. So, alin dito ang kanyang remote interior angles? So, take note, we're talking about the interior angles. So, syempre, dito tayo titingin sa loob. Itong tatlong interior angles na ito. So, alin dito ang remote interior angles of angle 5? So, ito yung angle 2 and angle 3. Bakit si angle 2 and angle 3? Because these are the two angles or the two interior angles not adjacent to angle 5. Kasi si angle 1 ang kanyang adjacent. So, ano yung hindi adjacent to angle 5? Na interior angles. So, we have angle 3 and angle 2. So, how about for angle 7? For example, angle 7. Ano yung kanyang interior angles? So, again, angle 2 is the adjacent angle of angle 7. So, ano yung hindi adjacent na interior angle to angle 7? So, yung hindi adjacent na interior angles ay angle 1 and angle 3. Hindi kasali si 2 because si 2 ay adjacent. So, dapat yung not adjacent to angle 7. So, the remote interior angles of angle 7 are angle 1 and angle 3. What about angle 9, for example? Angle 9 is an exterior angle. So, what are the remote interior angles of angle 9? Again, hanapin natin yung interior angles. So, these are the interior angles. Pero, dapat not adjacent. Since si 3 ay adjacent to angle 9, so hindi kasali si 3. So, ano yung dalawang interior angles na hindi adjacent to angle 9? So, these are angle 1 and angle 2. So, how about angle 4? Ano yung remote interior angles of angle 4? Again, hindi kasali si angle 1 kasi si angle 1 ay adjacent to angle 4. So, ano yung hindi kasali, ano yung hindi adjacent? So, you have angle 2 and angle 3. So, pareho ang remote interior angles of angle 5 and angle 4. Same with angle 6 and angle 7. Kasi angle 6, yung adjacent na interior angle niya is angle 2. So, hindi adjacent ay angle 1 and angle 3. So, yun din ang remote interior angles of angle 6. Pareho sila ng angle 7, angle 1, and angle 3. Same with angle 8. So, yung two interior angles niya are the remote interior angles are angle 1 and angle 2. Angle 3 is not included because it is adjacent to angle 8. So, si angle 8 and angle 9 ay pareho sila ng remote interior angles. Angle 4 and angle 5, pareho din sila ng remote interior angles. Same is true with angle 6 and angle 7. Pareho sila ng remote interior angles. Okay, this time, try to answer what is being asked in the problem or in the activity. So, I will be giving you 5 minutes to do the work. Okay, time is up. So we're now going to answer. Number one, we have, name all the exterior angles. Now remember that when we say exterior angles of a triangle, these are the angle which forms a linear pair or adjacent with one of the triangle's interior angles. So we have angle 5 and angle 7. So angle 5 is adjacent to angle 1 and it forms a linear pair. Angle 7 is adjacent to angle 1 and it forms a linear pair. So for angle 2, adjacent angle is 6 and 8. So the exterior angles are angle 6 and angle 8 because angle 6 is adjacent to angle 2 and it forms a linear pair. Angle 8 is adjacent to angle 2 and it forms a linear pair. So for angle 3, adjacent angle is angle 4 and it forms a linear pair. Another adjacent angle for angle 3, to angle 3 is angle 12 and it forms a linear pair. So the answers or the exterior angles are angle 5, angle 7, angle 6, angle 8, angle 4, and angle 12. Now for number 2, name all the interior angles. Pag sinabi natin interior, those are the angles inside the triangle. So we have angle 1, angle 2, and angle 3. Number 3, what are the remote interior angles of angle 5? So when we say remote interior angles, these are two interior angles not adjacent to angle 5. So if this is our angle 5, angle 1 is adjacent to angle 5. So ano yung interior angles na hindi adjacent to angle 5? So we have angle 2 and angle 3. Question number 4, what is the adjacent interior angle to angle 4? So asan yung angle 4 natin? Ito yung angle 4. So ang kanyang adjacent interior angle is ito. So adjacent na interior angle to angle 4 and that is angle 3. Next we have number 5. We're going to find the measure of angle 3. So saan yung angle 3 natin? So this is our angle 3. Now how are we going to find the measure of angle 3? Take note that angle 3 and angle 12 are supplementary angles. They are linear pair at the same time supplementary angles. When we say supplementary angles, the sum of their measures is 180 degrees. Now, since angle 12 has a measure of 125 degrees, so we are going to subtract this from 180. So 180 minus 25, this is 55 degrees. Okay? So kung i-add natin yan, 55 plus 125 ay 180. Therefore, the measure of angle 3 is 55 degrees. Next, number 6. We're going to find the measure of angle 2. Alin si angle 2? Ito. So paano natin kunin ang measure ni angle 2? Remember that the sum of the interior angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. Since angle 1 and angle 3 ay meron ng mga measure, angle 1 measures 68 degrees and angle 3 measures 55 degrees. So we are going to subtract this two angles from 180. So 180 minus 68 minus 65, this will give us 57 degrees. Therefore, angle 2 measures 57 degrees. Kasi pag i-add natin yung tatlo, that will give us 180 degrees. Next, number 7. Number 7. We are going to find the measure of angle 7. So this is our angle 7. We are going to find the measure of that. So take note again that angle 7 is adjacent to angle 1. And they are a linear pair. So at the same time, supplementary din sila. Again, pag supplementary, the measure or the sum of their measures is 180. So we are going to subtract 68 from 180 and that will give us 112. So the measure of angle 7 is 112 degrees. Next, we are going to find the measure of angle 4. So this is our angle 4. Now, paano natin kunin ang measure ng angle 4? So, take note that angle 3 and angle 4 are also linear pair. And they are also supplementary. So, dapat ang sum of their measures is 180. So, since angle 3 is 55, you subtract that from 180 and that will give us 125 degrees. So, angle 4 measures 125 degrees. So, another way to check kung tama yan, so tingnan mo yung opposite angle niya. So, angle 4 and angle 12 are vertical angles. They are opposite angles and they are called vertical angles. And vertical angles are congruent angles. Pag sinabi natin congruent, they should have the same measure of angle. So, angle 12 measures 125 degrees. So, expected that angle 4 will also measure 125 degrees. Okay? Next, we have angle 8, the measure of angle 8. This is our angle 8. So, how are we going to find the measure of angle 8? We are going to subtract 57 from 180. Bakit? Because angle 2, which measures 57 degrees, is adjacent to angle 8, linear pair. At the same time, supplementary. So, dapat ang sum nila ay 180 degrees. So, isubtract natin si 57 from 180 at yun ang measure ni angle 8. And that is 123 degrees. Our angle 8 measures 123 degrees. Now, number 10, find the measure of angle 9. So, this is our angle 9. So, paano natin makuha ang measure ng angle 9? Take note that angle 1 and angle 9 ay vertical angles. So, vertical angles are also congruent angles. Meaning, the measure of angle 9 and angle 1 dapat ay equal. Since angle 1 measures 68 degrees, angle 9 will also measure 68 degrees. Okay? Who get the perfect score? Very good. Now, tingnan natin itong angle 12. Okay? So, what are the remote interior angles of angle 12? So, if this is the exterior angle, si 12, angle 12, ito ang adjacent angle niya, si angle 3. Pag sinabi nating remote interior angles, yun yung interior angles na hindi adjacent kay angle 12. So, ano yung dalawang interior angles na hindi adjacent kay angle 12? So, we have angle 1 and angle 2. So, these are the remote interior angles of angle 12. Now, Our angle 12 measures 125 degrees. Angle 1 measures 68 degrees and our angle 2 measures 57 degrees. If we are going to get the sum of the two remote interior angles, 68 plus 57, that is equal to 125. Therefore, we can say that the measure of the exterior angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of the measures of the two remote interior angles. Okay, so let us have here another example. So I have here a triangle having three interior angles and six exterior angles. So we are going to find the measures of all the angles here. Now, given the measure of the interior angles as angle 1, 75 degrees, angle 2, 60 degrees, and angle 3, 45 degrees, we are going to find the measures of all the exterior angles. Let us start with angle 4. So, to find the measure of angle 4, tingnan natin, angle 4 is adjacent to angle 1 and it forms a linear pair and they are also supplementary angles. So, kapag sinabi natin supplementary angles, the sum of their measures dapat is 180 degrees. Now, since angle 1 measures 75 degrees, we are going to subtract this from 180. So, 180 minus 75 degrees, that will give us 105 degrees. So, therefore, angle 4 measures 105 degrees. So, another way of checking is we are going to add 105 degrees and 75 degrees. And if that will sum up to 180, therefore, our angle 4, which is 105 degrees, is correct. So, tingnan natin. 105 plus 75 is 180 degrees. Okay? Next, we have angle 5. How are we going to find the measure of angle 5? So, same. Angle 5 is adjacent to angle 1 and they are also supplementary since they are linear pair. So, we are going to subtract 75 from 180 and that will give us 105 degrees. So, 105 plus 75 is 180 degrees. Now, another way of checking, look at angle 4 and angle 5. Angle 4 and angle 5, as discussed earlier, are also called vertical angles. So, kapag sinabing vertical angles, they are also congruent angles, meaning they have the same measure. Okay? So, if angle 4 measures 105 degrees, so angle 5 must also measure 105 degrees. Next, we have angle 6. We're going to find the measure of angle 6. So, angle 2 and angle 6 are adjacent angles. They form a linear pair and they are also supplementary. So, we are going to subtract 60 from 180 degrees and that will give us 120. Because since they are supplementary, dapat ang sum nila or sum of their measures ay 180 degrees. So, angle 7, same. They are, angle 7 is adjacent to angle 2. It forms a linear pair and they are supplementary. So, dapat ang sum din nila ay 180. So, we are going to subtract 60 from 180 and that will give us 120 degrees. Again, another way of checking. So, angle 6 and angle 7 are vertical angles. So, dapat congruent din sila. Same ang kanilang measure of angles. Okay? Next, we have angle 8. Angle 8 is adjacent to angle 3. They are linear and they are supplementary. So, we are going to subtract the measure of angle 3, which is 45 degrees, from 180. So, 180 minus 45, that will give us 135 degrees. So, kung i-add natin yan, 180 degrees. Now, what is the measure of angle 9? Take note that angle 3 is adjacent to angle 9. So, they form a linear pair and they are also supplementary. So, dapat ang sum din nila ay 180 degrees. So, since angle 3 ay 45 degrees, isubtract natin ito from 180. So, 180 minus 45, that will give us 135 degrees. And another way of checking again, tingnan natin, angle 8 and angle 9 are vertical angles. So, dapat they are congruent angles. So, angle 8 is 135 degrees. So, angle 9 must also measure 135 degrees. Okay? Now, we are going to identify the exterior angles and the remote interior angles. But before that, balikan natin yung exterior angle natin. Say for example, 135. We have here 105 and we have here 120. As discussed earlier, exterior angle is equal to the sum of the two remote interior angles. So, we have here 135 ang measure ng ating exterior angle of angle 9. So, ano yung two remote interior angles of angle 9? Pag sinabi natin remote interior angles, those are two interior angles not adjacent to angle 9. So, since angle 3 is adjacent to angle 9, ang angles not adjacent ay si angle 1 at si angle 2. So, if you are going to add 75 and 60 degrees, that will give us 135 degrees. So, that is one way of checking also kung tama ang ating mga binigay na mga measurements dito. So, for halimbawa angle 5, angle 5, which is an exterior angle, measures 105 degrees. So, ano yung two remote interior angles of angle 5? So, we have angle 3 and angle 2. So, if we are going to add the measures of these two remote interior angles, the result is 105. And that is the measure of the exterior angles. Okay? So now, we are going to list down all the exterior angles. So, from the given illustration, the exterior angles are angle 4, angle 5, angle 6, angle 7, angle 8, and angle 9. So, what are the remote interior angles of these exterior angles? So, let us start from angle 4. The remote interior angles of angle 4 are, we have angle 2 and angle 3. Hindi kasali si angle 1 kasi adjacent sila. Pag sinabing remote interior angles, two interior angles not adjacent to angle 4. And that is angle 2 and angle 3. So what about for angle 5? So pareho sila ng remote interior angles. Kasi angle 1 is adjacent to angle 5. So ano yung hindi adjacent to angle 5 na remote or na interior angles? Those are angle 2 and angle 3. So si angle 4 and si angle 5, pareho sila ng remote interior angles. What about angle 6? The interior angle adjacent to angle 6 is angle 2. And the two interior angles that are not adjacent to angle 6 ay angle 1 and angle 3. So yun ang remote interior angles of angle 6. We have angle 1 and angle 3. For angle 7, same. Si angle 2 ang kanyang adjacent, so yung hindi adjacent sa kanya ay angle 1 and angle 3. So for angle 8, adjacent si angle 3. So ang hindi adjacent na remote na interior angles ay si angle 1 and si angle 2. So pareho sila ng remote interior angle ni angle 9. So we have one or angle 1 and angle 2. Now we are going to list down the measures of the exterior angles and also the measure of the remote interior angles. So for angle 4, the measure is 105 degrees. Angle 2, we have 60 degrees, and angle 3 is 45 degrees. So same for angle 5. We have 105 degrees. Pareho sila ng remote interior angles. Our angle 6 measures 120 degrees. At ang kanyang remote interior angles ay angle 1 that measures 75 degrees and angle 3 that measures 45 degrees. So same sila ng angle 7. Pareho sila ng remote interior angles. So for our angle 8, the measure is 135 degrees. And the remote interior angles are angle 1 and angle 2. Angle 1 measures 75 degrees and angle 2 measures 60 degrees. Angle 9, ang pareho sila ng remote interior angles of angle 8. So angle 9, 135. At a remote interior angles ay 75 and 60 degrees. Now observe that the measure of the exterior angles is greater than any of the two remote interior angles. So itong interior angles natin ay greater than the measure of any of the two interior angles. So kung titingnan natin dito na mga interior angles, greater ang ating exterior angles dito. Or kung ito man ang gagamitin natin na interior angle, still greater pa rin ang measure ng ating exterior angles. So we can say that exterior angle is greater than one of the remote interior angles. So kahit saan na interior angle ay greater ang ating exterior angles. So ang kabaliktaran nito, any remote interior angle is less than the exterior angles. So kung ito ang gagamitin natin or ang titingnan natin na interior angles, ang kanilang measurements ay less than the measurement of the exterior angle. Kung ito din ang gagamitin natin or titingnan natin, still less siya o less than siya sa measure of the exterior angles. Now, we can say that The measure of an exterior angle is always greater than the measure of any of the two remote interior angles in a triangle, and that is what we call the exterior angle inequality theorem. So ito yung sinasaad sa exterior angle inequality theorem. Sinasabi dito na ang measurement daw ng ating exterior angle is always greater than the measure of any of the two remote interior angles in a triangle. Now, before we end, let us answer this activity. Fill in the blanks to complete the theorem. So, we have side angle inequality theorem or unequal sides theorem. So, it says that if one side of a triangle is longer than the second, then the angle opposite the longer side is larger than the side opposite the second side. Angle side inequality theorem or the unequal angles theorem. So it says that if one angle of a triangle is larger than the second angle, then the side opposite the larger angle is the longer than the side opposite the second. Next we have triangle inequality theorem. In a triangle, the sum of the lengths of any two sides is greater than the length of the third side. Next, we have exterior angle inequality theorem. So it says that the measure of any exterior angle of a triangle is greater than both of the non-adjacent interior angles. Okay, so that's all for today or for today's video. And thank you for listening. Watch for the next video lesson. Thank you.